Friends, I am your friend Dr. Paras Mangla, again with you with the plant kingdom classification. So yes, in my previous lecture we have done dicotyledons, first subclass, first family Magnoliae. So now today we are doing the second order nymphales. So as I have just a quick recap. What we have done in my previous lecture is I have told you that plant kingdom is classified into two subgroups, basically two subgroups, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Monocotyledons have four subclasses and dicotyledons have six subclasses. This classification is given by Dr. Michael Yakir, an Israeli botanist and turned homeopath. This classification is based on Conkers classification, and Dr. Mahesh Gandhi, our teacher, he has given us the age personal evolution module, in which he has divided these subclasses, each subclass, into different age groups. This is based on Eric Erickson's evolutionary age classifications. So our first subclass is Magnolidae. So the theme of Magnoliidae, it's a quick recap. We have done in my previous lecture also. You can watch it on YouTube. So the theme of first subclass is confused. First subclass is, they are very primitive plants. They are very primitive plants. So their skin is not yet formed. Their ego is not yet developed. Eye is not developed yet. So there is a lot of confusion, not hair filling. Escapism, lot of drugs are there, primordials, ideal existence, weak ego, ego is weak, mind is weak, inability to protect themselves, exposed, no boundaries, no skin. There are a lot of fears and anxiety, lot of feminine characters are there, because as I have told in my previous lectures, up to third first subclass, there are a lot of, they are mainly the feminine characters. In fourth subclass, then the masculine part start erupting, and in fifth and sixth subclass, they are mostly masculine characters. So in first three subclasses, there are lot of feminine characters. So there are left-sided remedies, lot of heart affections are there. So lot of hormonal, uterine and fibroid problems are there. Fluid related problems are there. So sensation of first subclass is confusion, bewildered, beclouded, feel isolated, not part of it, and the reaction is withdrawal. So whole first subclass, so the symptoms prevail. So there are a lot of hand gestures are there, clouded, confused. They cannot correlate with the things, like we have done in the Nux Mostrata yesterday in my previous lecture. Well-known states are not aware about them, just confused about the well-known states. The reaction is collapsed, stupefied, fainting, sleepy, blank, floating. They are watery plants, that's why they are floating, unconsciousness. And active reaction is withdrawal. Because they are confused, they are not related to the outer world, so they shut themselves. They shut themselves in their own world, because outer world is strange. So if we compare it with the minerals, so we can compare it with the mollusks, which are also very primitive animals. And in the minerals kingdom, they are with the second row, lithium line, but left side of the second row, and hydrogen series. And compensation is easily adjustable, adaptable to strange, new, confusing, bewildered situations. So today my topic is nymphales. So in first subclass, two orders are there according to the Eric Erickson's age classifications and Dr. Mahesh Gandhi's personal evolution model. They are placed in the womb stage, Magnoliales and nymphales. They both are in the womb stage. So in nymphales, there are two families, Nilumbonacea and Nymphinesia. Theme of nymphales, confusion of mind, impatience, contradiction form. Love animals form. This is very peculiar symptom or theme of nymphales. They have great love for animals. They are sympathetic for the animals. They feel the pain of animals. And there is a lot of physical weakness. Sexual desires are increased, but great weakness after performing, or even after nocturnal emissions. Now, first medicine of nymphales, Nilumbo nucifera. The subclass is Magnolidae, order is nymphales, family is Nilumbonacea. Lotus, Indian lotus. This is a very sacred flower. In Indian mythology and Buddhist mythology, this flower has a great significance. This flower represents calmness, purity, lot of spirituality, religiousness, and it is also known as Indian lotus or sacred lotus. They are primitive aquatic plants suspended in water. If you see the lotus plant, lotus flower, it is suspended in the water and flower is hanging with a weak stem. Its proving was done by Dr. Nancy Herrick of USA. On one hand, on the proving, they show excessive moral sensibility, pain on witnessing the suffering of animals, great impatience of slightest contradiction, great spirituality, calmness, relaxation of mind. Lot of provers given the symptom that there is great clearness of mind in morning, energetic in mind, emotional, and lot of provers gave this symptom that they feel very energetic. They want to research. They want to search the Google and do the work while in the morning. So this reflects in the rubrics also. Delusion, angels of. Delusions, imaginations, angel of. People's are angel. Delusions, position possessed he or she is. Doubtful souls of. Welfare of. Dream disconnected as in a. Dream clairvoyant. Grounded feels, anxiety, irritability with, quick to act, well say he is when very sick. I have taken in my vision software the criteria 40 medicines, maximum 40 medicines, and Nilumbo nucifera is one of them, and on that basis I have selected this rubrics. On one hand, these are showing a picture of very calm, relaxed person. And on the other hand, they are confused, anxious, fearful, abruptly mood change. They cannot concentrate on one subject, indifferent, apathy to other. And this reflects in the following rubric. Answer aversion to general snappishly. Anxiety persuaded as if. Anticipation as of evil impending. Confusion of mind, cannot tell what is real, what is not. Confusion of time, mind, time about. Despair, hell or heaven, did not care whether he want to. Dream as in a sleeping or awake, cannot tell whether. Dream bombs, dream nuclear, dream building collapse, demolished. Dreams murdering mother, only single remedy Nilumbo nucifera is there. Dream persuaded of being, dullness alternating with clearness of mind, fear murdered of being, fear danger of impending, handle things cannot anymore, overwhelmed by stress, meditation difficult, and there is energy lots of sleep desire to with, and there is lot great physical weakness, restlessness, with excessive sexual desire, and sexual exhaustions, especially in male after nocturnal emissions. Second remedy is Nymphaea odorata from the same order, Nymphales, and the family is Nymphaeaceae. Not much literature is available for this remedy. This is a very short remedy. Only I got just three rubrics, three symptoms about this. There are less vicious dreams, feeling of dullness, slight increase of sexual feeling at night, especially in females. Another remedy is from the same family is Nuphalutium. Nuphalutium, there is excessive moral sensibility, giving one great pain when witnessing the suffering of animals. Impatience at the slightest contradiction. Excessive sensibility giving one pain in witnessing suffering of animals. They feel the pain of animals. They cannot see the animals in a pain. The rubrics where this medicine was available is impatience, contradictions from slightest, animals, love for suffering, sensitive, oversensitive, moral impression too. They have great moral impression. They want to be very naive. They hold very great moral responsibility or moral values. They are sympathetic, compassionate animals towards. Feels great pain seeing suffering of animals. And on polarity, this ejection, troublesome, want impotence, wanting, impotency, impotency, ejection, troublesome, ejection, seminal emissions during sleep or stool, Nuphalutium, pollution, seminal emissions, generally without erections, sleep during. So these are the few rubrics where Nuphalutium is present. I am very thankful to my teachers, Dr. Rajan Shankaran, Dr. Mahesh Gandhi, Dr. Mikhail Yakir, Dr. Suresh Chhotra, and all the mentors and the other Song Academy. Thank you very much. Thanks for listening.